Doesn't matter, Captain Vlosh. I will leave it at 4K for one, say.
Salute to all viewers and subscribers. Welcome back. It's a new year, new adventures, and something new. We will actually assemble the first plane on the video because it's going to be fast, according to the manual.
Well, I hope, eh?
So what do we have today? Explain, Robert. You know this better than me.
Yeah, tell me quick, what do you have?
It's an ultimate 3D from Horizon Hobby with safe and smart technology.
The ultimate plane, the ultimate biplane.
Which actually comes already with a Spectrum AR637TA receiver, which the only thing you need to do is to bind it with a sexy...
Which of course we will also use today. With the beautiful and sexy NX6, show it to me.
NX6.
And this will be the first time that we will set the plane on the video, and of course the first time that we will test this radio.
Yes, so if you do something wrong, excuse me.
Well, hey. Well, I will set the radio. You will assemble the plane, because with my crooked hand, it will take too long.
Yes,
but no, Captain Vlosh will assemble it quick, and how you will start.
No,
we will just go.
You will show what you will need to assemble the plane. You need, of course, the parts that comes with the plane, and the tools will be Spitzhange, needle nose pliers, wrench number 13 for the propeller, X-Acto knife, and two different Phillips screws, screwdrivers, and that's it.
Well, of course, if we will need something else, we will get it from the toolbox, eh, Captain?
Yes, but I think this will be enough. Now, we will start with what?
Well, you will start with the instruction manual, like every pilot should start. Don't guess, my friends, just take the instruction manual.
This is why you get this, where everything is explained inside.
Step by step.
Now,
and you will also
gear installation. Is the
and you will also follow it step by step. Show it
yes,
to me.
Yes, but first I will skip one step.
Now this is it. Go according
to
the manual.
I will skip one step and I will first remove propeller.
Well, this is something that you must do.
Because later when you will bind the plane with the transmitter, we don't want nothing bad to happen.
Never bind a plane with the propeller on, because you don't know what will happen. It can start and it will bite you.
Yes.
This is the first thing that you do. And when the radio is all set, leave it on the table. When the radio is all set, then you will put the prop on.
Yes. And now, as we said, we were going to start with the...
Step one.
We will need this. Step one is to put on the landing gear. You will tilt it like this.
Now, of course, if you are a pilot, it's good to have a beautiful stand to assemble the planes on. You can buy them or you can make yourself one.
Now, if you look carefully in the back, you will see that there are four screws. Three are threaded like this for the wood or plastic, and one is threaded like a bolt, a normal bolt for the
spinner.
For the metal, which goes to the spinner. Don't screw with that now.
Put this one with the spinner.
And use the other three to, because actually these are the only three screws, four, that goes on the plane. Now, you put it like this, and of course, it fits perfectly.
Well, it is the E-Flight plane, so it should fit good, huh? Look at
no
this.
No surprises here. First one, second one.
Well, this will be interesting video, Captain Vlosh. Hmm?
Third one, yes. No, it will not be a 5-minute video.
Yeah,
but nevertheless,
we don't even know how to make 5-minute videos. This is not the 5-minute
like
class on this channel.
I will change it. It doesn't work good. Where is that orange one?
What orange one?
That small one. This. Oh yeah.
Is that better or what?
It doesn't slip on the threads. Look at this. This.
Yeah, this comes with the planes also sometimes, because sometimes you do get the screwdrivers with the planes and save them, eh?
Yes,
because you can use them the next day.
Like this. And the good thing that you have used them, because this actually fits the best. Now, what's the next step? The next step is we'll tilt the plane other way, like this, and I will turn it like this. And we will start with horizontal stabilizers, which actually just, you just put them inside, you stuck them in, and then you have four clear
duct tapes,
clear duct tapes with no color, so you stuck them in like this.
First you will put one side, and one. Of course viewers, wait, Captain Blush, don't forget something, eh? What? Because here viewers, I will tell you, you have two rods.
Yes.
Wait, you have one steel,
and
you will use this one, the steel one, if you will fly this plane on 4-cell, and the carbon one, if you will fly the plane on 3-cell. Of course,
the metal tube is recommended to achieve correct CG using a 4S battery.
Yes, Captain Blush, and that now is why you will put in
the metal one.
The metal one, because I will fly this plane
with
a smart battery, 2200 recommended 4-cell.
Now, you
show
stuck,
me that. I will
you
come
stuck
close.
In the metal bar.
Now you stuck in the other one, like this. And you align that plastic there. And as usually,
yeah, look at this fit.
Perfect
hey.
Fit. Now stay here.
Uh-huh.
Now stay here. According to the manual, you see, you need four of these. Now, of course, if you won't disassemble this plane in the near future, you can also put inside here, because you can put the glue inside.
You can
a
put
little.
The glue, but we will put.
But we will put this see-through tape.
Yes. And this is why you need an X-Acto knife, look at this.
And this is why I love these planes, because later you can disassemble them and store them good.
And in also, if you put this on, look.
This will hold enough, look.
It will hold enough.
This and is more than enough.
It doesn't ruin the sexiness
of the plane, the look of the plane. And they have thought.
And as I said, the easiest way to get the foil off is with the X-Acto knife, like this. You put it on again, on this side, like this, and we will do the same.
Of course, you must tilt it.
The bottom, like this, and the connections we will put on later, when Robert will bind the plane with the receiver, because maybe you will need to adjust
the length.
The length, but we will do that afterwards. So we
because
don't have to disassemble it again and ruin the connection.
Yes, you can also, if you have the checker, the servo checker, you can put it to neutral, the servo, and then set the surfaces to be also neutral, but sometimes when you later plug the receiver, they're not in the neutral position anymore.
Yes.
So I always love to set all the surfaces manually and mechanically,
yes.
And so you have all the trims left in the radio for later if you will need them.
Yes,
I said good.
Now this is why we're going to skip that step here that says to connect all the push rods.
No, we will connect them later.
Now the next one is what?
The lower wing.
Lower wing, which is exactly why it's good. I have it like this. Now we have taken the bind cable and we have put it onto the top, so we won't have to disassemble it again.
Because you can bind your plane now, but I don't like to bind it in this position. I will bind it on the wheels.
Yes.
So I will need that extent for the binding, and with that extent, in fact, I will bind today this plane in the save mode. So you will have the save mode working.
Now, the
but show how good they have done to the antenna to 90 degrees. I mean,
yes.
This is great idea.
They have used like straw tubes.
Two tubes.
And they have put it here and one onto the front.
So now you
it.
Have the 90 degrees antenna. I mean, this is great solution.
Yes, and I was just checking this. This is the Y cable, so it doesn't matter which one you plug where. Because if you don't use a Y cable, normally the left wing, if you are into the plane, the left wing is channel number one, and I use this for channel number five. But that
yes.
is me, you can do it whatever you want. It's your plane, but this is what I do. Now, we will plug this in. First, this cable. Check before you plug it in. Okay, minus, minus, signal
yeah.
to signal.
Minus to minus and signal to signal.
Yes, brown wire to the brown wire, and the yellow, check it again, like this. Okay, now you will stuck this in.
Now, of course, later I will tell you that you have with this smart ESC, you have the two options to set yourself the plane, even with the reverse.
Yeah.
Which I won't, because the back wheel is so small here that I will not use this on our runway because we have grass. But if you have the asphalt, you can use the feature that this plane goes in the reverse, eh?
Yeah?
Yeah, of course, eh?
Now, the other thing you need to check is, before you will put in the wing screw, just slightly open it, you see? So don't pinch the wire.
Now just put the cables inside good.
Put the cables inside, like this. It's not corrupt.
And now you can close it good.
Like this.
Now it's this.
Now you will use this screw or some pin or whatever, wing holder, put it inside. Like this. Just like this, Chuck, let me see. Yes, like this. Put it in. Yeah, that's it.
And just
stuck it in and just counter or clockwise or counterclockwise,
that's
doesn't
it,
matter.
Eh?
That's it. The lower wing is done. We have put it in the wires into the receiver. Now we can proceed with the installation of
the wing. But already it looks so sexy, huh?
Now the next thing is
the upper wing, I think.
Upper wing, yes. You will use these supports later.
Later.
First, there are no wires here, nothing to connect, you just put in the wing. So, look at this.
Do you know what I'm thinking?
What?
If the sound will be great, because today, viewers, we have the first time that we have the background.
Yes,
it sure does. Of course, we have also here the lights, but the background, so we won't have that crazy echo anymore. We will still get two more that we will put to a side here and on this side, and then we hope to have a good sound in this workshop, huh?
Yes, and this is
for the future.
And this is for the commercials here, right?
Yeah, we will put on the banner that we got from the USA for the...
Yeah, and maybe some other, who knows?
Yeah, well, who knows, eh?
Yes. Now, to put the upper wing on, look, there is a notch here, or a lip, or a tongue, or whatever. You stuck it into here.
Underneath that, yes.
So this holds the upper wing. Now, you will stuck it in, like this. Well, that's it, or what? It's already in.
Hey. Huh? Yeah, but I have told you, viewers and my friends, hey, with the e-flight planes,
now,
you get what you pay for.
The other one, inside, click.
Yeah, and that's it, eh? Is it?
Look under, on the bottom, how it looks, you see? How it
holds. Oh, the perfect
fit. Now, the next thing is this wing supports. You cannot go wrong with this because it's labeled. It says top and forward, you see?
Top, yes,
top
yes.
Top and forward, and I will do it like this. Because here is a groove because of the support of the carbon bar.
So you put that one on like my this. Side, yes.
So this will be, let me see, if it, yes.
Yeah.
I will put them inside
just for the looks. Erotic look.
Now, we will do that first here.
This will be something.
I just put it like here. Well, let me see. There's nothing to it. Just put it under this. Like this.
Yeah, that's it?
That's it. Now, I will do this one, this side also.
Or will you secure this one first?
No. Maybe I need to start like this. Like this. That's it.
Yeah, but this is so simple, unbelievable.
Yes, but you can also disassemble this. Meanwhile, on the runway, when you talk to your friends, if you don't want this to put it a hole in the car, just disassemble.
If you don't want to risk these wings in the car, you disassemble them, in 2 minutes, eh?
This is the next
And now,
thing.
Yes, this you have to secure.
These clips, secure clips, you put them in like this, according to the manual. I will tilt the plane.
Like this, yes.
You will see. Now, it looks to the up position, now. Stuck it in. Are you filming?
Yeah.
Like this.
Oh, you will stuck it in, Captain Blush. This is the first time that I'm filming, Captain Blush, when you stuck it
Look
in.
Look at this.
Yeah, but this is the perfect fit.
This was the virgin and it went in.
This is the first
Snuggly.
Time.
It was not easy, like usual.
Yeah, but the first time is always the hardest. But look at this, eh?
This. You put it in.
Do you have maybe different ones? Are all the same? Huh? No, 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 maybe you have the different angle. Yeah, but it is.
It is.
No, it is not. No, in the back, I don't see. Look in the back. Pull it out.
Mm-hmm. Wait, it's not right position for me to work.
Yeah, but
put
it
far away. Away. Uh-huh. Like this. I have to hold.
Which but can... are all the same? Uh-huh, they are all the
yes,
same
they are, but
shape.
I was just too far away from
yeah,
the wing.
Yeah, well, you were too excited, huh, Captain Blasch, because the first one went in so good yes. that you think that the second one will also, huh?
Yeah, if I would have like this. Now it's going up again. Ah. Like this.
And now you have it.
Yes.
Now look
well,
at this.
It's slightly awkward for me to go so far away from my normal stand, you know? You must understand me.
Well, of course, Captain Blasch, you're a little nervous because this is the first time that you're assembling the plane on the video, eh?
Yes, like this. Stuck it in.
Oh, like but this one went perfect. And you can see here that you can do this on your own.
Yeah. Like this.
But this is unbelievable, eh?
Salute first.
Salute quick.
For such an easy way
to assemble the plane.
Assemble the plane. No, actually the plane is assembled.
Yeah, but that's it, eh? Of course, we don't have the prop on, like we have said. We won't use it until the plane will be set in the radio. And now, Captain Blasch, will you grab the...
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it for this.
Yeah, for now it is. Just check quick.
What?
Open the hatch. If you have that connector for bind
yes.
close, is it?
I'll show you. It went a little bit in, but look at this.
Uh-huh.
It even says here,
and now
AS3X only.
And now I will show you how to bind this. You will grab the camera, Captain Blasch, or what?
Yeah, of course.
I will give it to you. Don't
turn it off, so all the work will go. So this is yours.
I don't have my hat, uh-huh, of course.
You don't need a hat, you're hairless anyway.
Here,
you're anyway hairless, so who cares,
say?
So this is it, you yes. say. Salute once more with the hat. And now, like I said, of course, Captain Blasch, thank you for the assembly of the plane.
Yes.
Of course, later you will also assemble the rest. But the point is, viewers, that we will now plug the plane in the battery, set it to the radio, so we will have all the servos in the neutral, because it's important that you set these ones, that they will be in the neutral before you will connect them with the upper one.
Yes.
So you don't have like this, the ailerons, that will be nothing. So this is it, I will turn on.
You must first turn it on?
This will be for the first time, you were saying.
Oh, you have chosen a good color, eh?
So this is it, and now look, where will you feel?
Whenever.
Where can you feel that I will
do stand like
prepare.
This.
Prepare. Do you see it?
Yes.
Now, of course, we have the option on this plane, now on this radio, the NX6, that we already have prepared the template for this plane.
Yes.
We will just choose it. We will go to the system. Model select. We will put a new model. And now it will ask you here, do you see this?
Yes, which?
And you have the bind and fly version, do you see this? And now you press. Create, and now you can choose here the plane, because all the e-flight and the fly zone planes are already inside, and we will find the e-flight, the ultimate.
It goes
e-flight
carbon Z,
just check ultimate. Do you see here?
Yes.
Now you have two versions, like I have said. One is with the reverse and the other one is without. Now I will set without. I will just check. Reverse, no reverse. Now this is the one. Do you see this? Say?
Yes.
This is the one without no reverse. Import. Do you see this?
Yes.
And now we have the ultimate with no reverse here, already all set. And you will see now that also all the knobs are already set for you.
Sure.
I will make the sound. I will make the more sound so you will hear it. I will put it to 80. Now here, you push this one, go to the back, And then you can set yourself the volume, the
speaker volume.
The speaker volume.
Volume 80.
Now we have on 80 and now listen, you will see this. Now, so here you have the throttle cut, I mean you have the gear, you have the throttle cut already, you have the rates for this plane already, and also the flaps. It doesn't have them, but they have put it...
Maybe for some later version?
Yeah. Who knows? I don't know, I mean not for later version, I don't know why they have put it the flaps, but who cares? You have the flaps, which in fact you won't use. And this knob is now free, and we will use this one for the safe selection. And now here is the point, of course, you have also set the timer here. Now if you will go to timer, you go to timer here, we will see countdown over 25%. Now I always put myself above 5% of throttle, it starts to count. And of course we will go here and I will put here the voice. Now I will set this later. I put on all the events, I put myself the voice so I can hear it for the radio to talk to me when it's time to land and all that. Now I will go back of course here and we will bind this. You also have in the system setup the bind, but today I will bind this in an old fashioned way. I will turn off the radio now. I will turn it off. And I will bind it with this bind knob here. Now, if you want to set yourself the safe, now here is all the magic. If you want to have the safe select on the radio, now it's important what you will do. Now, I will put the bind plug in the bind cable here.
Yes, which is why we have left it outside.
Like this, and now it's important. If I will now put the battery inside and leave the bind plug, and turn on the radio, I will only have the AS3X working for me from this receiver. But if I will put in the battery now, and then when the receiver will start to blink, I will unplug the bind plug and then bind the plane with the radio, then I will have the option for the safe select. So this is it, understood?
No, I didn't understood, but anyway.
If you want to have only the AS3X on the plane that you don't want to have the safe select on, you leave the bind plug inside. You don't take it out when you're binding with the radio. But if you want to have the safe select, you will see now, I will, look at this. And now I will put the safe select on this plane. I will put the battery in. Now it has started, did you hear the sound?
Yes.
And now I will put out the bind plug. And now I will bind it with the plane. Well, it's binding. It's still binding.
Do you think you should take this out?
Bind failed. Unplug it. Let's try again. The bind failed. Now you should take it out because in this way you will have...
Wait. But how would the receiver know that you're binding the receiver? This is what I don't understand.
Well, yeah, of course it knows. I mean, this is... Well, we will try again. Because this is the new version of... The receiver. Now I will bind failed. I will turn it off again because I bind the E-flight planes like this, Captain Blood. This is not the first time.
Well,
yeah, hey.
It's not for me to know because actually I don't know nothing about this.
But that is why we are trying DSA, because it should work like this. You plug the battery in.
Now leave it.
Now you plug it out.
Are you going to do it again?
I will try again. But I already hear some strange noise.
No, 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 it's not okay.
But what's this? But it should bind like this. Binding. Or we will see the next time.
No, 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 you must leave that plug-in.
Yeah, plug-in, but then it won't help, but this is nothing. Because if you want to have the safe select, no, I will leave now the plug-in. And I will just bind it, bind fade, I will bind it in the old-fashioned way like I did in the past.
Yeah.
I will just go here, I will put the bind plug-in. I mean, this is interesting. Now this is, you see that we didn't test this before on the camera.
Yes.
But these are some new receivers, some I wonder. I will now leave this in. And of course, I will prepare now.
You bind it with the transmitter?
I will go to the system setup, yes, I will bind it like I always have bind it. Here you have the bind. And now let's see if this will work.
Like this. Now go away.
I will go away. Yeah, but already here.
Yeah, but now do it. That's it. I told you so, eh?
Yeah, I told you so. Yeah,
but there is no logical explanation how to bind it with the bolt without bind plug.
But no. The point is that the bind plug is in when you start with the battery, but then you remove it, so it knows that you have the safe select. But I mean, even here it says like this.
Yeah, maybe no, you did it on the wrong step.
Elevator, the rudder end, the throttle. We have
that's it.
Yes. So now, Captain Lush, you will do what? Of course, I must now unplug this, put the bind plug out.
Everything is in neutral position.
So let's check it once more. If I plug it in now, without the bind.
That's it.
And that's it, eh?
Yes. Maybe you didn't read good, eh?
Yeah, didn't read good, eh? Now, of course, what should we do? Yeah, nothing. You will put the battery in, and now you will set the...
Yeah, why did you take it out now?
Yeah, but you will plug it in again. You know how to plug the battery.
What? Grab it?
Yeah, remove it.
Yeah, I'm waiting for you to grab it.
So this is it, but this is really strange, eh?
As I said, I never have seen binding the blade without the bind plug, but maybe that's just me.
Yeah, I did have the bind plug in, but what's with you?
Yeah, but when you...
But
you
when you plug the battery...
to bind it, you took it out before. But who cares, we are now doing other stuff. So, ailerons are working, now we will start with...
And now check if you have the ailerons in the neutral position.
Yes.
Is it good? Yes. They are pretty good.
They are pretty good, yes.
And now you can set yourself...
Now I will set...
The this. Connections.
Which actually are... Look at this. They are actually on spot, we will see.
You will put them down first.
I will stuck it in. Like this.
And now check this, you must have surface level.
They are perfectly leveled.
Is it?
Yes. Now just use this.
Check if you have the right, if you turn it correct.
What?
This on top, you must have turned it in the right way.
Yes.
Is it?
Here is the bigger gap, here is the smaller gap.
Okay.
Like this, yes. Like this. Now try to put it in.
It will not go like this, Captain Block.
Yeah, but it's smaller on this
side. Yeah, but it's okay. But you can't put it like that because the bolt is sticking out and now it is on.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I can do it with the needle nose pliers.
Yeah.
But looking at this...
Yeah, it's not the same. Yeah, I have tested this many times because it looks like it is the same viewers, but in fact you must turn it in the correct way so it slips on pretty sexy and easy.
Yeah, slips Yes, it must sleep inside. Yeah. It sleep inside very sexy. Now like this, I will put this through here.
Well, we're still learning. We're a little stiff here on this video of yours.
Well, it's first time for us. So
yeah, but you can see here.
I wonder how relaxed were you first time, eh?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think so.
Hey, check the ailerons quick. And of course, later viewers, now we have all the travels, the ailerons, the elevator and the rudder on different knobs. But in fact, you can all set them on the single knob. So if you switch one knob, you will set the low rates or the high rates on all the travels, say.
So now we will put
The elevator. First put it in the servo arm.
Like this. I just wonder where to put it. On which? I'll put it to the second one, huh?
No, put it to the outer one, huh? Does it show in the manual? Did you check?
No, I didn't check.
Now usually we do put it on the, I put it usually on the outside.
Okay, I'll put it on the outside. Like this.
And now check. Check if it is leveled.
Yes, it is.
I mean, if it is not screwed too much, then you can later just trim it quick in the radio, if it is not much. No. But sometimes it is so way off that you will use half of your trims just to set it. So is it? The elevator?
Elevator? No.
And now just check if the rudder is okay.
Because everything was already set up for you, you don't have to set nothing.
Yeah, this is
just
it.
Just check it. Ailerons! Elevator up, elevator down, rudder left, right, gas.
Now, of course, viewers, you must still check, check if the throttle cut is working.
Which one?
You have the throttle cut, that one, yes.
Wait.
Throttle cut on. Throttle cut, you see this?
Throttle cut on.
Hey, this is amazing.
The other thing is what next?
The next thing is...
I'll just stuck the battery like this. Yeah, I'm not strapping in.
No. I will, viewers, later, of course, also check if I need to sub-trim something to the perfection. Yes. But all in all, the plane is almost assembled now.
Throttle cut on.
Now, this is the time when you can put on your propeller at the end, when everything
but
is
But even
up,
we have put the throttle cut, which we will today believe that it works perfect.
Yes.
But still, yeah, of course it does work. But still, viewers, if you do this at home, unplug your battery just in case.
Feel here. This is the last thing you will do.
You put it back
because
on.
Because it is not gasoline or glow engine. You don't need to worry about the position of the propeller. You just do
and,
it.
And tight it with the feeling.
With the feeling.
Don't tie it too much because this is aluminum.
Yes, now this is the last thing you put on, is the spinner. You just look if it is aligned with the hole, like this.
Oh, this looks so great, eh? And you will use the last screw.
The last screw that was provided with the plane, which is...
You will use the second one. This one is magnetic, Captain Bush. This one here.
The black one?
Yes, I use this one because it has a little magnetism.
Yes, just a little, as you have said, just a little. Actually, I'll do it like this. This.
Is it?
I hope so. I think it is. Yes, it is. If you can do it like this, tilt the plane, and that's it.
And that's it, eh? All that is left now, you have here this...
Carbon bar,
if you will fly this plane on 3S, and that's it.
I don't think that you will, but you can save this for some other plane. Now, we will check the throttle. I will stand behind the plane.
Grab it firmly.
Grab it.
Throttle cut off. The back of the... You have
well, that was close, eh?
You almost tilt over the background,
almost,
eh?
I almost threw it over the studio. Now, well, what to say?
Yeah, this is it, eh?
That was... I was a bit clumsy because this is the first time I have assembled a plane on video, but I think that we...
And you didn't assemble much foam planes by now, eh?
No, and I think that we have given you a lot of useful informations.
Well, I think that we have shown you all, my friends, what you need to know to assemble this plane. Of course, And you still need to fiddle a little with the radio and with the plane, and that's it.
One more check.
Now the throws are big. You have, I think that you have set this 100% throws and the 70% throws, which in fact I will also set myself the third one with the 50%.
Which is ailerons?
Elevator, low rates,
elevator, high rates, aileron.
No?
Aileron, low rates. These are the low rates?
Uh-huh, wait.
Now, I will leave it like this and you will listen.
Aileron, mid rates, aileron, high rates. Ah, do you see this?
Now, for the elevator. Like this, and that's it.
Hey, but this is one amazing birthday.
What can be more easier than this?
Well, I don't know, eh?
That you can assemble it so quickly without editing, which we usually do, which was... I had a few issues, but that is just me, because I was too nervous.
Now, of course, viewers, I will still check... I will still check that safe select on this plane. And of course, oh, Captain Blush, turn it in once more.
What?
We will show it the next time.
What?
We will show, because now we have the smart radio, the informations from the receiver.
You will show that on the flight?
No, of course, yours. I will show you that before I will start
this
the flight.
This is the assembly video.
I will show you the informations that you get on the radio about the battery, the motor, the temperature and all that. We will check that on the maiden flight video.
Because you will actually... know this more than me.
Yeah, of course, this was the first time, you excuse me, but hey, I will set this like it should be, even with the safe select, and I will tell you next time what it was. Maybe
you should be, you know, maybe what was your fault.
Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe you should do it like you did say, but inside the transmitter, not like this.
Yeah, yeah, in the inside. Or maybe you should push the button on the receiver, because this one is like those antenna-less receivers that you in fact push the button on the receiver and then you bind it. But viewers, but hey, this will be...
do it like this, well, it just...
This will be for the next time, eh?
Just take two pins out,
yeah,
on one,
it's not the problem.
Plastic screw, and that's it, and you're in the receiver.
And that's it, eh?
Yes.
So this is it, viewers, what to tell at the end? Hey,
well,
one amazing plane already, and it looks so
even
sexy, huh?
I'm a balls guy, I was impressed, hey, because this was so easy to assemble, eh?
Hey, but it looks so good, eh? And I think that this will be one hell of a flyer,
you know,
huh?
Usually, before I go to fly, I have to assemble the plane for at least 20 or 30 hours. This was in, what, 20 minutes?
Yeah, and that is why I love foam planes, and thanks to God, Captain Blush loves the Bulsa planes, so we cover them all on this channel, and that's it.
That's
so this is it, Captain Blush.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blush signing off from Slovenia with beautiful Horizon Hobby Ultimate 3D with AS3X smart technology built in.
Which in fact can be your first biplane or not, who cares, eh?
Who cares?
But believe us, eh, that it looks pretty sexy, eh?
Yes.
And we can't wait to test it. So this is it. Viewers, thanks again for all support and just expect more, eh? I can't wait to take this to the runway, Captain Blush.
Yes, I believe you.
So this is it. Cut.
No cut.